But before all that, new government figures show the average age of farmers across the East is going up. It's now reached 59, and worryingly, there's little sign that the younger generation are attracted by the profession.
Well, now a woman from Great Yarmouth is trying to buck that trend and has enlisted the help of Fixers. It's the campaign that gives youngsters a voice to get her message across.
I'm working here at home. In the morning, I'll help open up. There'll be maintenance of the machinery around, checking the crops as well. I couldn't imagine doing anything else. My name is Emily Page, I'm 25 and live near Great Yarmouth. My fix is to try and get more young people to take up careers in agriculture. The farm has been in my family for over 100 years now. I'll be the fourth generation to take over the farm, so it's something I'd like to even see a fifth generation perhaps take over. Not anytime soon, but one day. I trained to be a graphic designer, but I realised I wasn't happy and I was choosing to go ploughing rather than sit at a sketchbook. So I went back to my roots. My father was thrilled when he found out I wanted to take over the farm, and that's given him a newfound enthusiasm to invest into technology, different bits of equipment, all social media as well, like Twitter and Facebook.
If family hadn't decided to take it on, then that would sort of eventually been the end of the farm. With the graphics background, she's very good on all the advertising and that sort of thing. She's got all those ideas what I wouldn't have.
Since I've got back into agriculture, I've realised there is a shortage of young people in the industry, which is such a shame because it's such a fast-moving industry with all the technology that's evolving, and there's no one to help that progress even further. With Fixers, I'm developing a film that will help encourage young people to take up a career in agriculture.
I don't think we're in crisis, but there is a major problem. The food and farming sector has the second oldest workforce in the UK, and with increasing technology coming in the industry, we need more high-caliber young people. The perception of the industry outside is low pay and bad conditions, but actually, you know, with the high-tech industry that we've got now, you can actually earn quite a reasonable wage and have a really good, exciting career.
Yes, it is hard work, but it's so rewarding seeing the whole cycle. You're involved in every single bit of the process, and it's fantastic seeing the results of all your work come together.
I stop for a cup of coffee, and my office is an open field. Such fantastic views.
Today I've brought together a group of friends who some are already established in agriculture and some are just now beginning to start out.
It's probably still perceived as a dirty, smelly, you know, sort of dusty...
Long hours.
Long hours, yeah.
Quite unsociable.
Yeah, but people forget that you're sat in a tractor now, air conditioning, got your iPod plugged in, whereas go back 30 years, you wouldn't even have a cab.
So there's lots of interesting jobs out there, agronomy being one, but there's lots of other technical roles such as fertiliser input roles and precision farming techniques and drones.
You don't need to come from a farming background at all. If anything, we need more people like that to help take the industry even further.
But obviously I don't come from a farming background and I find it really, really hard to get into. Since apprenticeships come about, it's become a lot easier and you can access a lot more information like online, and organisations like Young Farmers, they really help because they provide a lot of training.
Since starting the small flock of sheep, I found people really, really accepting, you know, that I actually want to do something, you know, and get into the industry.
I hope my project will get young people to really get enthusiastic about agriculture and take part in something that is such an important part of everyone's lives.